I want to know why I haven't been permitted to see Mrs. Rath's will.
Why should you? You're not in it.
I don't believe that.
Very well. Go and take a look for yourself. It's on file right here in South Bay with the probate judge. What's his name? Bernstein.
And the will's no good because she told me I was in it.
Now, look, Edward. I don't know what's come over you, but Mrs. Rath was pretty confused toward the end, and you know it. She didn't even know what she had to leave. But I can tell you that it wasn't much, and I can show you figures to prove that, too. But I promised her that I'd look after you, and I'm going to try to keep that promise. I mean, for one thing, you'll always have a home in this house.
What do I want with your charity? I've probably got more money than you have. What I want is what she promised to me, and that's what I'm going to get to.
You mean she promised you some sort of pension?
She promised me this house.
This house? Well, that's pure nonsense, and you know it.
Well, why else do you think I stayed on here? Taking her crazy orders, cleaning dirt up after her. You think I love that old woman?
Don't speak like that about Mrs. Rath again, Edward.
I'll sue you, you know. I've got money. I can get a lawyer. I can get the best lawyer in New York. Nobody's going to swindle me out of my rights.
The will leaves the house to me. The only question now is whether you're going to be sensible about this and take what you can get, or whether you're going to keep shooting your mouth off and get thrown out of here tonight.
I'll get out, all right. Don't you worry about that. But I'll be back. And don't you forget that either. Either you're trying to cheat me or she did. That crazy old woman. She was filthy. She never bathed enough.
Now get out of here. Go pack your bags and... If you're not out of here in an hour...
You want to be sorry for this?
Call a taxi if you want it, but don't come out of your room until it gets here.
All I've got to do is to show my proof. And that's what I'm going to do.
You know Mr. Schultz, of course.
I do.
I apologize for this way of going about things, but... I'd like to see if we can't solve this little problem without bringing you to the strain and bitterness of a trial. I don't think any of us want anything like that. Now, here are the two documents of the case. The probated will, the photostated contract between Mrs. Rath and Mr. Schultz, bearing Mrs. Rath's signature.
Doesn't a document like that need to be witnessed?
Not necessarily. Not if the court decides it represents the intention of the deceased.
That's quite true, Mr. Rath. Mr. Schultz seems to have been doing a little research.
My lawyers told me.
You did more or less everything for Mrs. Rath, I believe.
Everything. I was the only one she had in the world. Take care of her.
Shopping, cooking.
Everything.
You also paid the monthly bills?
I made out the checks according to the bills and she signed them.
He had to. Her sight was just about gone.
Oh, she could sign her name all right. Look at the checks if you don't believe it.
I didn't say she couldn't.
Well, what did you do? Did you type them or write them?
I typed them.
Well, now we come to the most distressing part of this case. This is the part I'm sure none of us would like to see come out in open court. I regret to have to say this to you, Mr. Schultz, but... You're a dishonest man.
I'm dishonest?
I'm afraid you are. And the reason I say that is I have here a list of 6 South Bay tradesmen who are prepared to swear that you asked them to pad Mrs. Rath's monthly bill so that you could get a kickback.
Oh, I know that crowd. They're sore because I wouldn't give them her trade.
And you wouldn't mind if we subpoenaed these people?
Why should I?
Also, I was astonished to learn at what an enormous bank balance you have on your salary.
I don't know what kind of monkey business you're up to, but you can't get that information from a bank. It's against the law.
$78,462.09. Mr. Rath's account is just under $9,000 in one deposit.
Did the bank tell you that?
Oh, you can't get that information from a bank. You told me that yourself.
If the bank told you that, they told you a lie. I haven't got anywhere near that much money. And I'm going to find out from the bank just what they did tell you, too.
You wouldn't mind having your accounts examined by the income tax people?
Anytime they want to.
I realize very well that I'm exceeding the prerogatives of my office, Mr. Schultz, but I assure you my only intention is to save you from making a serious mistake if these particulars were brought out in a trial, as undoubtedly they would be. And it was then suggested that Mrs. Rath was so old, so nearsighted, that she would sign anything you put in front of her. Don't you see what that could lead to? But if you have a perfectly clear conscience about this matter and are prepared to explain the circumstances satisfactorily.
Never mind telling me what I can do. I've got lawyers that can handle that sort of thing. And believe you me, they will handle it too. You wait and see.